So I got an email yesterday, and for once, it wasn't a stupid question or somebody submitting a request for the naughty list or anything like that. And it's titled, The Taste of Human Flesh.
Sounds like a movie on Chiller Channel.
You know that doesn't even exist anymore? They say it wasn't drawing enough money or something like that?
Well, there's a lack of appreciation for good indie horror. It's a jump scare market now.
I could have saved Chiller.
Here it comes.
Pending ridiculous, asinine, dumbass, Bacco movie idea in 3, 2...
If they would just release Hairy Beast of Preschool, they would have gotten their stupid human ratings.
Of course, such an underrated title right next to Teenage Sandwich Bag Sex Fiend, right?
You should read the email before he begins telling us the plot.
It's about a 9-year-old hairy cannibal who's got a chicken rib stuck in his throat, and he's...
So we got an email!
Bitch.
Titled, The Taste of Human Flesh. His name is Levin. He lives in Oswald Heights. It reads, Dear Madam Cross, I've obtained a new obsession, and I'm not sure if I should feel bad about it. A few weeks back, I accidentally hit a backflip off the second story balcony of my building and busted my face up pretty good. Well, no shit! What do you mean you accidentally backflipped off the second floor?
He accidentally did?
Yes! What kind of drugs?
He accidentally did.
Oh my god. You're one of these idiots who falls off a tower trying to catch all the pretty invisible acid trip butterflies, aren't you?
Oh, that hurts my brain. That hurts my brain.
He seeks to defy gravity. Admire his innovative stupidity.
Oh, he'll innovate something, all right. I landed on my face, and one half of my bottom lip was hanging by a small thin strip of skin. Well, morbid curiosity took over, and I decided to eat it. He fucking ate it.
His own lip.
His own lip. His mother didn't love him, Shug. From that point, I slowly began to appreciate the taste of flesh. Just the warm, tender skin, the warm blood. Just contact with it makes my mouth water. Oh god, he's turning into Bacco.
He's going to kill someone. That's what he'll do.
The tenderness of human flesh is irresistible. It's a God-given right to enjoy it.
I don't think God tells people to eat people, Bacco. Crazy cult people and Trump supporters do that.
No, I've eaten many Trump supporters. They are just as afraid to die as any tasty mortal. They just taste slightly better with relish.
So saying eat me to a guy like this won't be such a good idea.
No, it wouldn't, because he'll obviously break out the A1 sauce. I don't know what to do. Part of me wishes to further indulge this curiosity, that's smart. But the other side tells me not to do so. I'm conflicted. I find myself licking my arms and chewing on my fingers often. I have dreams of eating myself on the dinner table. I see my aunt's speed bag arm fat, and I'm absolutely allure. What the fuck?
I'm sorry.
This is why I don't go up there. This right here. What should I do, madam? I love the show, and I listen every night. Keep up the good work.
Oh boy, the zombie apocalypse is upon us.
Okay, Levin, you want to go around eating people? First things first, okay? You need to stop sniffing those damn bath salts. That's your problem. You're probably so fucking whacked out of your mind right now that you don't even realize you sent this to me. You probably can't hear a damn thing I'm saying right now because you're probably ass naked on the bathroom floor howling at the moon right now.
I hear bath salts has a synthetic meth in it. It's odd. I use bath salts often enough when I bathe. I wouldn't have thought that.
Yeah, I heard something like that. But yet again, Shug, you're not stupid enough to sniff it.
I sniffed them by mistake one time. It wasn't pretty when I came to.
You're never pretty when you come to.
Neither are you, bitch. I'll eat you right now.
Oh, so you want to taste my rainbow?
Never mind.
What's his name? Levin, is it?
Yes, Levin. He'll be on the most wanted list soon, so...
Okay, Levin, if you're listening, you need to know the consequences of eating human flesh. I have used many different types of skin in my potions, both animalistic and voluntary human. The vast majority of people who chew on themselves do not seek professional help. Most people grow out of it, but those who don't, it may cause a lot of mental issues later on in life. More than simply making your fingers look gross.
I think he's already hit the mental downfall state, Shug. He sounds like a guy who gives Freddy Krueger nightmares. He'll become Fruity Krueger after he beats poor, fucked up Levin here.
He's got an issue, certainly. He has dermatophagia. It's a compulsive need to bite yourself. Usually it's just your hands and your fingers, but this guy is licking himself like a dog. He wants to bite his aunt's arm, for Christ's sake.
He ate half his bottom lip, Shug.
Yes, that's disturbing. I mean, for this city, it's not surprising, but still. The major impact this will have is on his mental state of mind. Because chewing your flesh really won't harm your insides, unless you manage to dip yourself in some kind of poison.
Which you'd be screwed anyway.
Yes, he needs help. His curiosity is dangerous right now. The dreams are dictating that. And no, you shouldn't indulge yourself on eating more flesh. You're already at the front doorstep to insane by asking this. You sound like you belong with the vampires in this city, but even they wouldn't welcome you. This is a bad taboo with a bad curiosity growing, Levin. I'll send you a potion if I need to. I don't want you to turn into Baco.
Why is my eating habits the subject of ridicule all the time?
Because you're unnatural. You're a natural abomination. Your eating habits offend people.
Oh, but then I'm bad for eating the offended people. The way you humans think is the reason you're not at the top of the food chain.
Look, Levin, I agree with Shug. You need to get some help because you're really, really fucking close to going out in the street and making black man casserole or white girl lasagna. I'm afraid for you, so any police in this city listening, you need to find poor Levin before he eats, you know, some gothic pasta. He can't be free and be out here eating my ghouls. Baco is enough to deal with.
I don't eat 24/7. I have a strict time of when I consume.
Yes, all 12 hours a day.
I want to say something to the puny human as well.
What could you possibly tell him? How not to get shit stuck to his fur?
Shut up! Levin, eating human skin is a joy and a given right. It's nutritious and it's nothing to be ashamed of. Go out there and eat until your heart's content. Just be smart about blood types.
You're telling a guy who accidentally backflipped off his second floor balcony and obtained an urge for cannibalism to make smart choices.
On second thought, never mind. You're a fucking idiot.